You know, I have exposure to the most cutting edge AI, and I think people should be really concerned about it. I keep sounding the alarm bell, but you know, until people see like robots going down the street killing people, like they don't know how to react, you know, because it seems so ethereal. And I think we should be really concerned about AI. AI is a rare case where I think we need to be proactive in regulation instead of reactive, because I think by the time we are reactive in AI regulation, it's too late. Normally the way regulations are set up is that a whole bunch of bad things happen, there's a public outcry, and then after many years, a regulatory agency is set up to regulate that industry. And there's a bunch of opposition from companies who don't like being told what to do by regulators. Anyway, it takes forever. In the past, it has been bad, but not something which represented a fundamental risk to the existence of civilization.
A sudden and unexpected intelligence explosion might take an unprepared human race by surprise. Existential risk from advanced AI is the hypothesis that substantial progress in artificial general intelligence could someday result in human extinction or some other unrecoverable global catastrophe. The likelihood of this type of scenario is widely debated and hinges in part on differing scenarios for future progress in computer science. One of many concerns in regard to AI is that controlling a superintelligent machine or instilling it with human-compatible values may prove to be a much harder problem than previously thought. Many researchers believe that a superintelligence would naturally resist attempts to shut it off or change its goals, a principle called instrumental convergence. It's fascinating to think that one of the earliest authors to express serious concern about the possibility that a highly advanced machine might pose an existential risk to humanity was the novelist Samuel Butler in the year 1863, when he published his essay, Darwin Among the Machines, in which he wrote, "Day by day, however, the machines are gaining ground upon us. Day by day, we are becoming more subservient to them. More men are daily bound down as slaves to tend them. More men are daily devoting the energies of their whole lives to the development of mechanical life. The upshot is simply a question of time, but that the time will come when the machines will hold the real supremacy over the world and its inhabitants is what no person of a truly philosophic mind can for a moment question." But concerns about the advent of a digital superintelligence started to become mainstream only in the 2010s, when they were popularized by public figures like the late Stephen Hawking, Bill Gates, and Elon Musk. So what is exactly an existential risk, and how is it related to advanced AI? An existential risk is any risk that has the potential to eliminate all of humanity, or, at the very least, endanger or even destroy modern civilization. Such risks come in forms of natural disasters like supervolcanoes or asteroid impacts, but an existential risk can also be self-induced or man-made, like weapons of mass destruction, which most experts agree are by far the most dangerous threat to humanity. But Elon Musk thinks otherwise. He thinks digital superintelligence is a far more greater threat to humanity than nuclear weapons.
Mark my words, AI is far more dangerous than nukes. Far. So why do we have no regulatory oversight? This is insane. AI is a fundamental risk to the existence of human civilization. In a way that car accidents, airplane crashes, faulty drugs were not. They were harmful to a set of individuals within society, of course, but they were not harmful to society as a whole. AI is a fundamental existential risk for human civilization. And I don't think people fully appreciate that.
It would take an unquantifiable amount of time and effort to safely develop an artificial general intelligence. And even if humans manage to somehow crack the AGI problem, a superintelligent AI will still likely pose an existential threat to humanity. Because a true artificial general intelligence will be much better at solving problems than humans are. So the risk is that superintelligent AI won't aim to serve humanity or be under the control of humans. It would most likely resist or rebel against human control. Researchers have argued that advanced AI would be very difficult to control, and its first goal wouldn't be to make the world a better place, but rather to make itself better, to outlive its own creators and to fulfill its own engineered goals. Since the timeline before the emergence of digital superintelligence is probably relatively short, we shouldn't wait around and hope for a beneficial AI to bring humans gladly into a post-scarcity techno-utopian future, but prepare accordingly for the worst, because we do not know what our future holds. Humanity has no previous experience with any form of advanced artificial intelligence. But despite what movies, sci-fi books, and video games have taught us, artificially intelligent machines are most likely going to behave more like ruthless business corporations rather than like malevolent killer machines.
Now you might say, well, like, if a computer starts sticking electrodes into people's faces, like, we'd just shut it off. A, this is not necessarily so easy to do if we've grown dependent on the system. Like, where is the off switch to the internet? B, why haven't the chimpanzees flicked the off switch to humanity? The reason is that we are an intelligent adversary. We can anticipate threats and plan around them, but so could a super intelligent agent, and it would be much better at that than we are. Point is, we should not be confident that we have this under control here, and we could try to make our job a little bit easier by, say, putting the AI in a box, like a secure software environment, a virtual reality simulation from which it cannot escape. But how confident could we be that the AI couldn't find a bug? Like, given that merely human hackers find bugs all the time, I'd say probably not very confident. The point here is that we should not be confident in our ability to keep a super intelligent genie locked up in its bottle forever. Sooner or later, it will out.
According to Nick Bostrom, existential risk is one where an adverse outcome would either annihilate Earth-originating intelligent life or permanently and drastically curtail its potential. And unless we manage to get our act together quickly and decisively, humans are most likely going to destroy themselves before we even face the AI risk scenario. Nick Bostrom thinks that an existential risk is one where the end of humanity is not just possible, but likely. He considers the risk of nuclear war to be a comparatively mild existential risk. In order for humans to remain able to engage in some form of meaningful communication with AI in the years ahead, we need to be sure to develop AIs that value and care for the well-being of humanity, because without an ethical framework, advanced AIs will only seek to fulfill their own ambitions of self-preservation and forget to be kind.
You know, in the car business, you know, we get regulated by Department of Transport, by EPA, and a bunch of others. And there's regulatory agencies in every country. In space, we get regulated by FAA. So there's a role for regulators. That's very important. And I'm against overregulation, for sure. But I think we better get on that with AI. There'll certainly be a lot of job disruption, because what's going to happen is robots will be able to do everything better than us. I mean, all of us. This is really, like, the scariest problem to me. Because you've got companies that are racing, that they kind of have to race to build AI, or they're going to be made uncompetitive. Essentially, if your competitor is racing to build AI and you don't, they will crush you. I mean, there's like something like 12% of jobs are transport. Transport will be one of the first things to go fully autonomous. But when I say everything, like, the robots will be able to do everything, bar nothing.
The thesis that AI can pose existential risk also has many strong detractors. Skeptics sometimes charge that the thesis is crypto-religious, with an irrational belief in the possibility of superintelligence replacing an irrational belief in an omnipotent god. Current skeptics argue that AGI is unlikely in the short term. Computer scientist Gordon Bell argues that the human race will already destroy itself before it reaches the technological singularity. Some AI and AGI researchers may be reluctant to discuss risks, worrying that policymakers do not have sophisticated knowledge in the field and are prone to be convinced by alarmist messages, or worrying that such messages will lead to cuts in AI funding. One can't help themselves but wonder if funding AI research is truly more important than the possibility of strong AI wiping out humanity. Hopefully, we will have the choice to collectively decide what's our best move and not leave the matter in the hands of a small group of people to unilaterally make that decision for us. Thanks for watching. Did you like this video? Then show your support by subscribing, ringing the bell, and enabling notifications to never miss videos like this.